Now we learn how to calculate the centroid of this right circular cone. Right circular cone. Here the base radius of the cone is r and height of the cone is h. Base radius is r and height of the cone is h. So this cone is rotating about this horizontal axis. So x is the horizontal axis. And perpendicular axis to the x is W1, Z and Y are the two other axes. X, Y, Z. These are the three axes of the solid. Right. So, from this diagram, we can say one thing is it is revolving or rotating about x axis. So, that other two coordinates of the center of gravity, Y bar and Z bar is equal to 0. And we have to calculate only this x. Because we know center of gravity here is it is a three-dimensional object. D is a consist of x coordinate, y coordinate, and z. So from this diagram we can say one thing is the centroid or central gravity of this solid is lies on x axis. Central gravity of this solid lies on x axis. Okay, so let us take for calculation of this center of gravity, we have to assume one differential element. So we need to assume like this. So I already drawn that the differential element. So this is a disk differential element. Of thickness dx or radius r, which is x distance, any arbitrary distance x from the origin or vertex of your point. It is the disk is the element, differential element is a disk of thickness dx radius r, which is x distance from the origin. Okay, so for this disk, we have to calculate first weight. After that, we have to calculate the weight of the total. So, weight of the disk. Weight of the disk, we can calculate. So we have this dW here, there is still a different element. dW is equal to density into volume of the disk. Density into volume of the disk. So volume of the disk. DV is area into thickness. Here area is a subject of disk. So the radius of disk is R. So that the area is pi r square and the thickness is dx. Here the differential element is dx. So here in fact we need that pi r also variable here. R also variable because it's a disk radius. If x is integers, r value is integers. That we can observe in our diagram. You see the, our diagram. This is our disk. So x is a variable, means if x is travels from 0 to h, and this r is also variable. If you see here, this r value is 0, small r value is 0. If x is increases, this small r is increases to capital R, small r increases to capital R. So r is variable and x is also variable. So in this case, in this case, if you observe this equation, this volume is equal to pi small r square into dx. Here, small r is available and dx is a differential equation. Both are in both are not same. So we have to write the small r is in terms of x. Small r is right in terms of x. For that, I am taking its similar triangles. So if you see this cone, so here we can observe triangles, two triangles you can observe. Triangle O, A, B is one triangle, and triangle C, O, C, D is another triangle. Then we can observe two triangles. O, A, B is one triangle, O, C, D is another triangle. So in this two similar triangles, so X is the height of the smaller triangle, that is O, C, D, and H is the height of the bigger triangle, that is O, A, B. Similarly, base of the bigger triangle is capital R, and base of the smaller triangle, is small r. So from that, from the two triangles, that is triangle O, A, B is one triangle, and triangle O, C, D. From this, we can write this height, smaller triangle height is small x, and height of the bigger triangle is capital X. Small h, height of the smaller triangle and height of the bigger triangle. This is equal to base of the smaller triangle is smaller and base of the bigger triangle is smaller. So, x we can write in term, r we can write, r is equal to, because r we need to substitute in above equation. So, r is equal to x by h into smaller. So then the volume will become by instead of r square we need to write x by h whole square is x by h smaller whole square is r value into d. R this is equal to pi small capital R square by x square capital R by x square into x square dx. This is the volume of element. And if you substitute the volume of element in our weight equation, that is weight of the element double d w will become rho into volume, that is going to pi r square x square. Then total weight for weight of the cone, total weight of the solid cone we can write w is equal to integral over the domain D. What's the domain here? So domain here it is, so you see the domain. So disk is traveling to 0 to this, that is origin to this. So along the x-axis, that is 0 to h. 0 is the minimum value and h is the maximum, correct? For the x, 0 is the minimum value and h is the the domain is 0 to, so we have to integrate the domain 0 to, right? Now we need to substitute the VW value. So for rho, pi, capital R square, x square is all the constants, and integrate for a domain 0 to x, x square, dx. Okay. So if you simplify this, so rho pi r square divided square, so x square integration is 2 by 3 polynomial of 0 to polynomial of 0 to. Then if you substitute the x value, so it will become rho pi r square x square. So rho by r square x by x. So this is the weight of the solid. So this is the density into solid volume. Density into volume of the solid. So this is the weight of the cone. Weight of the solid cone. So weight of the solid cone is rho into volume. Volume here is pi r square x by. Pi r square is the area of the cone. And so x by 3. So these are all calculated doing to find out what is the x coordinate of center, x coordinate of center of gravity. So we need to pronounce as a center of gravity. Center of gravity. So here, so the center of gravity is calculated based on our variance theorem. Variance theorem saying that total moment is equal to total moment is equal to sum of the individual moments. Sum of the individual moments. Here the moment is about x axis. So total moment, total weight into x bar is equal to individual center of gravity into x square theta of the element. Here the domain is the x value varies from 0 to h. X value varies from 0 to h. So the domain is the indication limit is 0 to h. So we need to substitute the dw value and we have to integrate with the limit. So what is our dw value? Dw value is, can we calculate this dw value? Dw value is rho pi r square by x square x square. So this is our dw value. Means here we can find a constant, so rho pi capital R square and the square of the constant integral of the element 0 to h. 0 to h. X into x square is, will become x to dx. Right. So to integrate this x to dx, it will become rho pi R square. So if you substitute this x value as a function, so rho pi r square x square h power 4 divided by 4. So first order element, but we have the square and the numerical shortfall there, but the denominator is square, you can look at cancel. So what actually it is W into X bar. So W we know actually W into X bar actually this value is W into X. So if you substitute this W as a value of W, we already calculated. Value of the W is rho 5 R square X square. Okay, R square X square. So here the translation terms are Y5 we cancel and R square cancel. So here we have X bar. So X bar value is X bar is equal to here we have an H and here it is H by 3 by 3 and here you can find the H square divided by 4. So H bar you can write X bar is equal to 3 by 4. X bar is equal to 3 by 4. Means the central gravity of this right circular cone is less on x axis. Lies on x-axis. So the value from the origin is value from the origin is this is our x bar is equal to sorry equal to 3 by 4 that is almost a 3 times. So if you divide H into if you made H into 4 regions, 3 half hour, that is 3 fourth of, this is our like this, we can calculate centroid of this right circular cone. Here the centroid of center gravity, because we center gravity is the most appropriate term because it is solid. So V is equal to x coordinate is 3 by 4 h, comma y coordinate is 0 and z coordinate is also 0. So this is the center of gravity of right circular and that are the